Anything important today? Oh my goodness. Is that a human? Plain human? Oh boy. Stay quiet. Luckily there's nobody around. I'm kind of alone. Stay in this part of the magical forest where there's no one. Do you have a hood on your sweatshirt? Put it. So if somebody happens to stumble by and see you, the hood will kind of cover your ears. So they would not notice too much. You have something covering your ears. Well, I would kind of notice because your clothes are not very magical. You're not from around here. Yeah, my first question would be, how did you get here? Some magical force. Oh. You found the cave entrance. It's not good. Kind of thought that was very hidden and no human would find it. But, yeah. I like you. You have good vibes, it seems. If you didn't notice, we have powers. Magical. We're in a forest. This is no place for a human. You promised not to tell anybody. This can't be known. And I would, I would lose my home, pretty much, if anybody found out that I am even talking to you and not alerting the other elves. Us and humans don't go together very well. You have to notice. This is a secret. We are actually forbidden to even leave the magical forest. But, between me and you, I have. I'd like to go and collect some rocks that aren't magical. I don't know, something different. And see wildlife that isn't magical. You know? Not as great as the sacred magical forest, of course, but I like observing something different. I can lead you out to go back home, but in the meantime, I get very good vibes and energy from you. But I can sense that you have quite a bit of negative surrounding you. Not that it's from you, precisely, but you're around negative things or just stress that can definitely linger into your energy. So, I'll just do my magical duties and help fix that for you. Yeah, I heard all about the human life, and it sounds very stressful. I'm sorry you have to go through that. Okay. Well, this is my favorite brush. We have to do this with other elves as well, because there are some elves that are allowed. A lot of us have to kind of bow down to them. They're still leaders in an elf paradise. And we have to cleanse their energy anytime they, you know, leave. But, you know, I've also had to do it myself. So, yeah. I'll get started. Sorry if I'm rambling a lot. But obviously you've never been here before, so... Close your eyes. Think of a happy place. Think of this place. Think of where you feel like home. Kind of helps get into your energy field. And feeling any better? I'm just going to be brushing with it. I have potions. I have what we call a magic crystal. You can find them kind of out in the wild here, in the woods, near water, pretty much. I have a special frog that makes noise. And I have water glow. They're just, they help us elves kind of relax and calm down. It kind of works with like meditation. I'll give you some of my magic potion, and that should definitely help with calming you down. This is something I carry on me at all times. The different crystals and herbs and stuff. Don't worry, might hurt a little bit going down, but I promise the healing properties among this potion is quite significant. Always. It's always an elf's duty to keep this on you. This is the magical crystal. It has quite a bit of powers. You can just hold it up close next to you, or you can just hold it in your hands while you're trying to relax. Here. Just hold it. Actually, you know what? You can keep it. I tend to find quite a bit when I adventure, so you can keep it. I think you need it more than me. This is my magical frog. Make a very great sound. I got some of the magic water from the pond. So this has some healing properties as well. Close your eyes and imagine yourself in your favorite safe space. If you need to stop by my part of the woods just to escape and relax, you're more than welcome. You know, rarely I'm a loner, but I don't mind the occasional conversation and hangout session. I'm a healer after all. I actually enjoy it. Those need it. You don't get to do it too often, really. And really, we kind of all keep to ourselves. There are some elf leaders that aren't so great, but what are you gonna do, right? You either stay here or try to survive as pulling off being human, I don't know. I would much rather stay in the magical forest. I've heard all these stories, you know, what it's like being human. We create and trade. Find our own place in woods and forest and just dwell. Gather our own food, grow our own food. Here things grow pretty quickly. Plants and such get all the nutrients that they need. We can continue making our potions, using our stuff for healing properties and food consumption. There's a lot of magical animals. Pretty great system. We actually have a treehouse. Some people, some elves like tree houses, some elves don't. I prefer to be home in a magical forest when you're up in your tree house. Because to die for. You feeling relaxed? Good. I can definitely sense it. You're pretty much cleared from the negative energy and whatnot. I'm glad I can help. It's nice meeting you. And I'll walk you back to the cave entrance. So, right now, it's probably not best to stay here as long. I'm sure you can buy some clothes that would help you blend in a little bit more if you ever want to come back. And we can try to do something to your human ears. Humans have costumes and whatnot. I think you can find ears similar to mine. Yeah. Great. I think you'll blend it just fine. Walk with you to the forest entrance. And I hope I can help. Feel free to come back anytime, and I would love to help heal you again. Okay. I can show you around a little bit. Maybe I'll run into some of the magic lights.